Our focus has been on the question that James asked in verse 13, who among you is wise and understanding? And we understand that that means who can take the thorough knowledge of God and apply it to their lives. Well, if you and I want to be wise and understanding, then we need a knowledge of God. We need God's wisdom, which in the Hebrew means to have the ability to see things from God's viewpoint. Well, if I need God's wisdom, how do you and I get God's wisdom? Well, we saw yesterday that it has everything to do with fearing the Lord, meaning we have a reverence and a respect for Him. And when we have that reverence and respect for Him, then that motivates us to receive Him, to receive His words, to receive His wisdom and knowledge. So that shifts our focus a bit today, because what does it mean to fear the Lord? We must recognize God for who He is, that He is the one true God, there is no other, that He is our Creator, that He is holy and righteous and just and majestic, that He is all-knowing, He is all-powerful, He is all-sufficient, that He is the Lord Almighty, that He is the Lord and Master, He is sovereign, He rules over every circumstance of our lives. It means we recognize that He created us and He's given us a path to salvation, offering you and me forgiveness for our sins. And ultimately, we will answer to Him. So we recognize that He is the judge. The question is, do you fear the Lord? Are you receptive to Him and His words, His wisdom and knowledge? Well, join me today and let's engage with God. Engage by listening, by receiving His words about His wisdom, so you and I will be wise and understanding.